My name's Matt Kaufman. I'm running for state senate, serving both Oldham County and Jefferson County.
Matt, what do you think are the top three issues facing your district?
Facing our district, education is a top issue. Working families fighting to survive is a top issue. That means affordable housing, that means good paying jobs, that means protecting our unions, all that in one. And another issue I think affecting every community is just the environment. Yet how are we using our resources and repurposing things and recycling and basically just thinking seven generations ahead. I would also say the toxicity in politics right now and a lack of engagement with people, that there should be more excitement about a primary right now. People should be engaged. And there needs to be some kind of bipartisan program that is reaching out to every single citizen and saying, these are your candidates for state senate. These are your candidates for house rep. These are your candidates for every single position that's out there. Here's their website. Here's their information. Here's where you vote, and make it more accessible. I've met so many people that don't know there's a primary, that don't know how to figure out what district they're in. And what I'm fearful of is that there are groups who don't want people engaged in our politics. But when we're more engaged in our politics are more honest, our values are more shared and represented, and they're more ours. If we're not engaged, somebody else is running the show.
Well, let's start with education. If you were elected to the Senate, what would you do for education in Kentucky?
For education in Kentucky, I would grow it. So Matt Bevin and current leadership, their first thing to do was to cut funding for education, saying there's not enough in our pension system. They didn't try to find any funding whatsoever. So we need to not only fund our pensions in an appropriate way and bring all stakeholders to the table, and it's transparency of process and product, but we also need to invest more in education. The research is out. Universal pre-K works. That gets kids' reading levels up, their socializing skills up, their cognitive abilities up, their emotional abilities up. I'm not talking about like just a public daycare for all. With universal pre-K, it's like a head start for all, setting those kids up for more success down the road. We need to grow more after-school programs. We need more mental and emotional health counselors in school. On average, right now in the state of Kentucky, we've got one mental and emotional health expert for every 1,200 kids. That is not appropriate. We deal with kids who've got a lot of trauma and they need more services. As an educator, as an English teacher, we're forced to wear many hats. So, you know, we are at one point in time, you know, a master of rhetoric and pass that on to our kids and make them writers. But we're also their therapist. We're also their parents. We're also their friends and their allies and a listening ear. We need a lot more resources to wrap around our kids to set them up for success. Oldham County loses a lot of its youth after they graduate from high school. People flock to Oldham County for the schools. The schools are amazing out there, but they need a community college. It needs to be a community college that the community itself takes ownership of. What kind of industry do they want to grow out there? So they need to think about and have a conversation about not just immediate wealth, but down the road, what's this long-term vision for Oldham County? And a community college is a way to do that, to keep your youth and to develop programs to create unique industries in Oldham County. So it's not just Wendy's and McDonald's passing, you know, coming up there, but other unique industries, something maybe even involving hemp. I could see Oldham County leading, I could see Kentucky flat out leading the nation in hemp and in hemp manufacturing and in manufacturing biodegradable plastics. I could see Oldham County and Jefferson County leading the way in creating networks between schools, nonprofits, local businesses, research and development, universities, where they're all partnering, working on bigger projects for themselves. That's much deeper learning. That's getting kids set up for those jobs. That's creating new jobs for those kids. It's a way to grow our most valuable resource, which is our people and each other, and a way to grow our economy. Too often, people just measure success by financial gains. But what is the health of people? What's their educational level of people? What are relationships like? What's our environment like? Education, I believe, can solve every single problem. It all starts there. So major things: fund Universal pre-K for everyone across the board. Get expert teachers in there. Build a community college in Oldham County that's unique for them. We need more mental and emotional health counselors in schools. Obviously, we have to fund our pensions in an appropriate way. The way teachers were treated by this last legislative session was disgusting. We need transparency of process and product. We need to involve all stakeholders at the table so we all have a say on this. We were locked out, it was shoved through, and there's a blatant attack on education right now. So a big thing that I will change once in office is I'll be a champion for education. As a school building leader, I believe you grow a school from the classroom out. As a state senator, I believe you grow the state from the school out.
So what would you do to help working families?
We need to protect unions. Right now, what I've seen over the past couple years is this group called ALEC coming in, the American Legislative Exchange Council, and there's businesses involved with them like the Koch brothers, and they wine and dine certain legislators, and then they give them bills, and they work to pass these bills. And this is why I say our democracy only works for us when we work for it. Those bills have been right to work, which cripples unions. Now what a union does, and while it's so awesome and why it is a family value, is that unions, the money that we pay our union members that are doing our jobs for us, that money stays in the local economy. If you bring a contractor in, that money goes right out. So that's a way to just keep and invest our money right here. If you're bringing in contractors to do the work, that work is not gonna be as safely done. And again, that money goes out of the economy. If you are closing down plants and sending your jobs overseas, not only is that inhumane for some of the slave wages going on overseas, but again, our investments are going overseas. Providing somebody a living wage is essential, and the right to organize and have representation in office with a union empowers working families. We need to have that. Oldham County needs more affordable housing. That's a definite issue over there. Environmental protections are also a major issue. As far as education, this is also gonna help working families. Right now, JCPS is being threatened with a takeover. They wanna bring in charter schools, they wanna bring in vouchers. What that's going to do is take kids who are already on the margins and push them off the page. Because these kids who will be going to charter schools pick those kids. They can dismiss those kids whenever they want to. And then this is our tax dollars, our public money, going to a charter school that's run for profit by a corporation outside of our state. So again, it's money going outside of our state when it needs to be invested in here. For private schools, these vouchers are not gonna pay for a whole private tuition. They'll pay for partial. So what that allows is kids who are already able to go to these schools will still be able to go to these schools at a cheaper rate now. But those kids who can't afford that, their resources are being taken from them, from our public schools, which is the great equalizer in our democracy. So for working families, we need to protect public education. We need to invest in it. We need to protect and grow our libraries. We need to protect our environment and not let our air and our waters be polluted.
That was one of the third things you mentioned. What would you do as a state lawmaker to protect the environment?
We need to build a coalition of states around us, around right now, with the Ohio River. The Ohio River is one of the most polluted rivers in all of America. And it gets polluted upstream and comes down. We've all got a vested interest in this. So we need to form that partnership and start cleaning our waters there. We need to clean our air quality. We need to, again, link our schools to research and development, nonprofits, local business, new technology, and start creating and building technology that can actually clean our water, that can actually clean our air, take carbon dioxide out of the air for us. That's thinking seven generations ahead.
Now, when a voter goes to the polls, if they're a Democrat, they might be thinking, which one of these candidates could actually beat the Republican in the fall? Mm-hmm. So why are you the candidate of the two candidates in the Democratic primary who can go on to win this seat in November?
The major things I'm running against, I'm running against apathy, I'm running against poverty, and I'm running against corruption. Right now, This district, 26, takes into consideration Oldham County and Jefferson County. I taught for 7 years in Oldham County. The campaign that's being run in Oldham County is run by my past students. They design my website, they do my literature, they're my field director, they're knocking on doors. Their families are helping them. Teachers in Oldham County are helping them. Unions are going out there and helping them. In Jefferson County, it's JCPS teachers knocking on doors, it's unions knocking on doors and doing that movement. I have the endorsement of every single major union in Kentucky. I've got educators in Oldham County and Jefferson County. I've got millennials. Every single door I knock on gets a sign in their yard. I find that when we talk with people and we elevate the conversation, people are excited and they want to be engaged. They're tired of the toxic nature in Frankfurt with the way politics is being done and the way our discourse has devolved to. In our democracy right now, we have a unique ability to build the kind of state we want to live in, but we're not being allowed to participate in that. And too often things are being passed behind closed doors that we're not seeing and we're just suffering from. And too often we don't care until it's too late. So I don't want to go to office. This was never a great big dream of mine. I was on track to go be a principal of a school. My dream was to build a school of deeper learners, where we're using the arts and using the sciences and this intersection of disciplines to create positive change in the world. That's a natural carryover to going to office. It's still coalition building. It's still learning our way through things. And it's still building the kind of world that we want to create. And what I've noticed is when people are passing bills in Frankfurt that hurt working families and hurt education and hurt environment, it affects all of us in dramatic ways. And we need people in office to champion working people, to champion education. I've got a strong reputation for that. I've been doing it for 11 years. In just 3 months, we built an amazing website. We're on track to knock on 5,000 doors. We've got the endorsement of every single major union in Kentucky. We're already building coalitions. There is a lot of excitement with this. So going there, I'm going to run above party. I think that we have a lot in common and that we're not as divided a state as people think. I think people are tired of the toxic nature of politics. I think they're tired of just voting straight Republican or straight Democrat. What they want is somebody who will deal with them honestly, someone who will involve them. I want to form advisory councils. Give me an agriculture advisory council. Give me an environment advisory council. Give me a infrastructure advisory council. I want to make internet a utility for all of us, because like education, that's a great equalizer right now. So we can get information, so we can run a business, those kinds of things. But I'm going to need a lot of smart, hardworking people around me to do this. So I need to build these positions and make this a team and collective effort and constantly reach out and engage people. Apathy is my number one enemy. We have to care what's going on right now. So even after an office, I'm going to be knocking on doors and I'm going to be saying, I need your help. I need to know what you are wrestling with. What are your views? What are your values? How can you do more than just vote? How can you also help lead from your unique position?
Matt, thank you for your time.